So how was yesterday? Did you have a good start to the business week? Good morning. This is Wake Up to Business TV, your Get the Business Day Started program. We are coming from Kingston Business Biscotti in Kingston upon Thames in Surrey. Just search online for Kingston Business Biscotti. You will find all the details on their website. I'm Richard Mitson from shoutpower.com. We've got two great guests who we've already introduced, of course, put forward by the organisers of this event. And ironically, they are two of the organisers of this event. I wonder how that happened, but anyway, we're also, of course, joined again by Neville Capadia.
Thank you.
Thank you once again from Think Slim and Trim, and also from John Ballard from Lime Time Apps, who we were talking about the pivoting as well. So let's look at some of the questions you've been asking, whether it's on the website or just topics which just keep coming up on business forums around the internet. Now, until we get fully underway, these are questions that I've spotted around the web. So first question was from Terry, who runs a computer repair shop. How did you define the perfect customer for your business so you knew who to go after, and what research did you do? So let's put that question, first of all, to Neville. How did you define the perfect customer for your business, and what research did you do?
Okay, so the perfect customer for my business, health, see, is someone who is serious about making a change. So the type of research or the type of evaluation, actually, that I would do is a question and an answer sit down to discover, what is there a real drive behind them wanting to make a change, or are they just saying they would like
to
be slimmer?
So there's a lot of people that want to get fit, but your target market is the people who actually do.
Yes, there's a lot of people that say yes and do no, but I want the ones that say yes and want to carry on.
Yeah. So how did you plan doing that, though? Have you just got people in the door and then said, let's do a survey, or how did you know what to ask them?
Okay, so we developed a philosophy of dangling the carrot to get people in on their own reasons why. So whatever the reason is, normally it's, oh, I'd like to lose weight. So come and discover how, as an example. Once they're through the door, that's when we sit down and really find out, do they actually want to do what they're saying through the question and answers in an evaluation? Or are they hoping for that magic miracle pill, magic bullet that we don't provide?
So from the example of Terry's computer company, we're sort of saying, look, when people come in the door, depending on what they want, you need to find out whether they're serious about buying a high-end piece of kit or a low-end piece of kit. I mean, this is something you can relate to, John, isn't it, as well?
Absolutely.
You know, how did you pick how do you pick the right people for your app business, which is totally different from what Neville's doing, obviously?
Well, as far as business apps are concerned, the audience really is small businesses who are keen about promoting what they're doing. So actually, how to pick those
ideal customers, because every business wants to promote itself. So how do you nail that down into who wants
that? Really, as far, you know, from that comes down to thinking about what we're doing as a business, and then thinking about a particular market, and then targeting those customers in that market area. So to give you an example, a while ago, we were looking at the schools market. So we actually targeted schools for the particular idea we had for an app. But then, at an earlier stage in our business, we weren't being quite so specific, so we were just looking at for anybody. And we just came up with a whole bunch of different people in business doing different things. And that was literally anything from pubs and restaurants, and we even had one lady who was a hypnotherapist, for instance. So a big range of different businesses.
Because one of the things that, I mean, I know about the tech world as well, is that there are people who are tech savvy and those who are definitely not. And trying to persuade people who are not tech savvy about the merits of technical stuff can be, well, just hard work.
That's difficult. And actually, the probably the hardest thing that we find is that that actually trying to get people to understand what is required of them,
yes,
to produce the end result,
yeah,
is actually a hard thing to do.
Yeah. Right, move on to the next question. Jane from Hounslow. She lets properties, buy-to-let properties, and asked the question, oh, this is to do with computers again, actually. With Windows unveiling their latest Windows system, which type of computers do you use in your business, and how do they help your business? John, we've got to come straight to you for that one. What sort of do you use Windows?
No,
Apple?
Well, I use Apple primarily, simply because Certainly, from when we started producing the apps, I need an Apple computer to be able to submit the Apple to produce the apps and to submit them to Apple.
Because you're doing them.
You
for
have
iPhones,
to have an Apple computer.
Saying, yeah.
You can't do it without.
Yeah.
And before that, I was using Windows all the time. But actually, now I've gone over to using Apple. I prefer it, and it's one of those funny things. And a lot of people use Windows and they don't get on with it.
Yeah.
And others do, and yeah, but I'll happily use.
So for
Windows
you,
as well.
It was actually crucial to your yeah. business model. What about yeah. you, Neville? Does it matter what you use?
I'm an Apple advocate for years and years and years.
iPhone, now, does it make any difference to your business, though?
For me, because I'm not one of these tech savvy people.
Yeah.
To me, Apple is so intuitive. It's simple. They're one of the big things, of course, is there's no bugs and viruses that attack it, so yeah. you don't have to worry about that. But also, it's obvious where things are kept on it. There's none of these odd files that you find on a Windows computer. I see my at home, they've got a Windows computer. And forever searching for things on it. To me, it's logical,
yeah.
an Apple. Although I have to say, we do have one at the Wellness Center purely because the program only runs on Windows.
Yes.
And that's the only one we have.
So your advice in that way is keeping it simple. Apple actually works for you as
well.
For
me, definitely.
You see, I'm very much a Windows man just because I love the fiddly bits. Because I'm a bit of a tech head, a bit like you actually, John. See, I don't want to use the simple stuff. I want to get in there and fiddle around with all the bits. It's nothing to do with my business. It's just me. Anyway, finally, final question. And one from a forum I spotted as well. Alex asks, did you do a business plan? Oh, great question, this one. And how useful actually was it? Neville, let's ask you about this one.
Short answer, no. And reason why, it's not required in the type of business I've joined.
Is this because you're using a franchise model? Or what you're talking
exactly,
about?
Because it's all done for you.
Yeah.
So there was no requirement for a business plan because there was no requirement to seek funding. Anything in that respect, so it wasn't actually required. You just duplicate what's shown
right.
to you.
Okay, John, what about yourself? Did you do a business plan, and was it useful?
But initially, I did a business plan.
Yeah.
So this is the company I'm running now, which is Lime Time, which is primarily for apps. That actually came out of my previous business, which actually is still running, which is websites.
Mm.
And now. For that, I did the full business plan, and that was 12 years ago, and so that was a business plan looking at the projected revenues and what the costs were, all the rest of it, and that was really, really useful because I was able to go and discuss that with my accountant and sort of decide whether what I was planning on doing was the right thing to do.
Yeah.
Now, having then 3 years ago now moving on to apps, because of the technologies being quite similar and moving that through, I didn't specifically do a business plan for that. I looked at what the target market might be and how I could actually use my existing business to sort of help promote that and go through there.
So you use that, but how useful has it actually been, apart from to explain to the accountant?
A business plan? No, a business plan is crucial actually because without it, you can't actually measure what you're doing and actually whether you know if you've reached the milestones that if your business is going in the right direction.
Yeah. See, this is the kind of advice you can get. I've said it before on this program, the kind of value you get from coming along to these networking events. John, just tell everyone about the event we're at again, Kingston Business Biscotti.
Yeah, Kingston Business Biscotti. We meet on the first Friday of every month at Las Iguanas, which is a lovely Latin restaurant that we're at now. And it's a free to attend, although we do ask for a small donation of £3 towards a tea or coffee that you might have.
Yeah, we should also mention where we are. It's John Saint Las Iguanas, which in itself is a success story. It started off as a small restaurant in Bristol in 1991 and now has 38 restaurants around the country. So another business success that we're here today. They're supporting us and we're supporting them as well. Now, tomorrow we're going to be chatting to John and to Neville as well in a bit more detail as we do some super mentoring where we're going to mentor each other. None of us have done this before, including me, so this is going to be a bit of a new experience. So we'll see you tomorrow. So have a fantastic and profitable business day.
Over the past few minutes, you've been part of Wake Up to Business TV. Now, carry on the conversation on Twitter at #WakeUp2B. biz, or go to shoutpal.com for links. If you'd like us to come to your event, it's free. Simply send us an email at info@wakeuptobusiness.com and we'll send you details about how you can use the show to promote your event. We hope to see you very soon.